Hi, this is Joy with Frugal Mini Mamas. Today I am going to show you how to make the Super Burritos freezer recipe. I'm making a double batch, one for dinner tonight, one to put in the freezer. These are the ingredients. We have the tortillas, butter, onion, garlic, taco seasoning, flour, rice, we need beef bouillon, chili powder, we need salsa. It calls for Frontera mild roasted salsa. I could not find it. I'm gonna just go ahead and use regular salsa. Hope it still tastes good. Mexican style cheese. I don't think you can buy this in a block because it is four cheeses combined. You have to buy it shredded. Ground beef. When I buy a big package of ground beef, I already brown it up and bag it in 1 pound packages. So I just thawed two packages for my double batch. And these pans that I got at Sam's. There are 30 of them in here. We're only gonna use two, but this will be a good investment. Hopefully I can use it all year long. You need to cover it with plastic wrap or press and seal and then aluminum foil. I ran out of heavy duty aluminum foil, so I'm gonna put two layers of regular and hopefully that works. A frugal menu mama does not buy already chopped onions. Instead, this is how she saves money and avoids chopping onions. This is my husband. All right, let's get cooking. All right, in this skillet, we put the ground beef, taco seasoning, water, onions, garlic, chili powder. And in here we're going to boiling water for the rice. So we're gonna wait and turn this on after the rice is done so we can mix the two together and fill up our tortilla shells. All right, we've got this meat mixture done and the rice done. So we're going to go ahead and drain the meat and then we'll mix the rice right in. All right, we are ready to start filling the burrito shells. I have the meat and rice mixture here. I have my two freezer pans here. I'm gonna go ahead and spray them with cooking oil. This is just a spray for cooking oil instead of using the canned stuff. We're on to the fun part, which is filling the burritos. I practiced on a few, and so I'll show you. All I do is spoon in the meat mixture with the meat and rice mixture, and then we will sprinkle some cheese on top and roll it up. The hardest part about this is keeping them rolled up.
And how do you do that?
I have secured them with a toothpick, but it doesn't really look like it's going to stay very well.
Manamana. Manamana. Manamana.
So I got a little too generous with the first pan, and those are packed full of meat. I'm running out of meat for my second pan, so I'm going to have to scrimp on the last one and only put five in this pan. All right, now we're going to get started on the roux. All right, I am melting the beef bouillon cube in the water and melting the butter to form a roux. A roux is just a mixture of flour and butter. It's used to thicken sauces, so we're gonna add some flour to this and once the butter is melted, and then we'll mix it all together. Alright, I've got the flour and butter melted in here, the water, the beef bouillon, and the salsa. We are going to stir and allow it to thicken. All right, we've got the roux done. It is not really as thick as tomato sauce. Maybe more like tomato soup. I don't know if it's supposed to thicken much more, but we've been doing this for almost about 5 minutes, I think. So we're just gonna go ahead and turn it off, pour it over the burritos, and sprinkle some cheese on. Alright, since the roux was a little hard to pour over, I want to make sure all the tortillas are covered. So I'm just taking a spoon and kind of evenly making sure they at least have a little bit of liquid on top. Alright, we're on to the last step, sprinkling cheese over the top. And these look delicious. Now we'll come back in a little bit to show you how to cover them. When you're freezing foods, you want to make sure they cool completely before you freeze it. All right, all our food is cooled. We're ready to stick it in the freezer. I'm gonna cover it with press and seal, or you could use plastic wrap. And then we'll put the foil on top of that. That just help it stay nice and neat. Also on the foil, you need to make sure you write your directions. You can use a label. I'm just gonna use a Sharpie. All right, I've wrapped the pan of burritos. It's labeled, ready to go in the freezer. So that is our super burrito recipe. Just wondering, made me start thinking, what is your favorite ethnic?